My name is Rose, and I'm from Syria, Mishli.
11-year-old Naroz and her family lived on a small farm in northeast Syria. It wasn't lavish by most standards, but more than enough for a family of seven.
Life before the war in Syria was great and beautiful. I went to school, and I helped my mom, and I played with my friend.
Naroz and her family decided to flee Syria in 2013 as the civil war intensified.
I left Kane because, like, before the war, I could go to school, and after the war, I couldn't. Before the war, I could play with my friend, but after the war, I couldn't. And we had, like, before the war, we had enough food and water and electricity, but after the war, like, we didn't.
The Yusuf family began their journey walking more than 30 miles to the Turkish border. They made their way during the night since it was just too dangerous to walk during the day. Many in the group took turns carrying a disabled member of the family on their backs.
I left my relatives and my farm, like my sheep and all of my other animals, and I left behind like my school and all of my friends. So.
After reaching the border, they were turned away by Turkish authorities and waited for 3 days without food or water. Naroz and her disabled brother Alan got very sick. Desperate, her parents pleaded for medical help and only then were allowed into the country.
After Syria, I went to Turkey and lived in Turkey about 2 years. I was just home and I was sad and crying because I couldn't go to school a lot.
Naroz's dad heard from a friend about the United Nations Refugee Resettlement Program. After applying, the family was interviewed several times. And although Europe and Sweden denied their application, the United States agreed to accept them.
I feel excited and happy because I'm going to go to America. Like, I'm going to have a future. I'm going to be safe in there.
After 2 years living in the U.S., Naroz is optimistic about her life.
I have a future, and my future is to become a doctor because I want to help all of the children in the world.